What's up, guys? I'm LQ, and this is the LQ Review, and I'm here to talk about Holiday in the Wilderness, the new Netflix original movie. Yes, I sat down and watched it with my wife, and it is it's okay. Let's talk about it. So it stars Rob Lowe, who, by the way, I love Rob Lowe. Love Rob Lowe. To me, Rob Lowe will always be Nick Andros from Stephen King's The Stand miniseries that happened in the 90s. I know a lot of people love him from Parks and Recreation and probably some other things, but to me, he's Nick. He is Nick Andros, and I love him. The other person that it stars is, what's her name? I don't remember her name. Kristen something. She's from Sex and the City. She was in Deck the Halls with Matthew Broderick and Danny DeVito. I'm going to get off on a side tangent here. Deck the Halls is objectively a horrible movie. I'll say it. Objectively a horrible movie. It's a guilty pleasure for me. I love watching Deck the Halls. I watch it probably two or three times every Christmas season. I just like Deck the Halls. It just makes me feel good. So she's in that. I don't remember her name. I feel really bad for that, but I don't remember her name. So I'm just going to call her Deck the Halls Lady. So Deck the Halls Lady in Holiday in the Wilderness, she ends up getting ditched by her husband. After their son leaves for college, they're empty nesters now. Literally the second that this kid leaves for college, I mean, minutes later, he walks out the door, dad leaves her. Her husband leaves her. After she says to him, I've booked us our second honeymoon to Africa. Instead of saying to her, boy, thank you for doing that. I think we should use this opportunity because I haven't been happy lately. And I think that maybe this will be a good opportunity for us to work on that and to see if we can repair our relationship. This will be a great, great opportunity to try to repair our relationship. Nope. Dude's gone. What? You booked Africa? Nah, I'm not happy. I'm out. This is crappy dude. Crappy, crappy, crappy dude. So she decides to go to Africa by herself, solo, as a kind of a way to just kind of heal. It was done better in Forgetting Sarah Marshall when Jason Segel leaves to go to Hawaii after Sarah Marshall breaks up with him. I digress again. So she goes to Africa on this big African safari tour type deal. And she's chartered a plane to fly her over the savannah to see all the animals, and the pilot is Rob Lowe. Well, while they're out there flying, so while he's flying her over the savannah, he stops suddenly. Oh, we go, hang on, we're going to go in for landing. And they go in for this landing, and they stop. And she finds out that he is there to rescue an elephant, a baby elephant that's mom was killed for its tusk. And they're trying to nurse the baby back to health. She wants to help. So she goes back to the elephant orphanage. And there she just falls in love with what they're doing. And she also starts to fall in love with Rob Lowe's character. And she's there for a long time, more than just Christmas, but kind of a lot of ways the climax of the movie takes place around the holidays. So was it good? Yeah, it was okay. It was okay. As far as romantic, I won't even call it a romantic comedy, maybe like a romantic dramedy. As far as romantic dramedies are concerned, it was fine. I wouldn't classify it as a Christmas movie at all. That was misleading. But it's definitely a romantic dramedy with some nice moments of levity to it and a nice message. You know, the message of conservation, the message of caring for nature. And, you know, this is all stuff that's present and it's all good stuff. Rob Lowe obviously plays a complicated character, somebody who has left the United, who's American, but has left the United States to stay in Africa. What drives a person to do something like that? That's explored a little bit. And then her passions and what she loves and what she wants to do is obviously explored as she decides where to go with her life after she's fallen in love with Africa and the elephants and all this stuff. So definitely an interesting story. Definitely worth a watch. I would say it's worth a watch. I wouldn't say that it's one of those movies that you're going to plug in and watch multiple times. It's definitely not going to be like a perennial Christmas classic because it's really not a Christmas movie. There's just parts of it that happen to take place during Christmas. When they say Holiday in the Wilderness, I think they're referring to her vacation. Her vacation, which her vacation, I believe, starts in like September, maybe August. And then she stays through the new year when she hadn't planned to. You know, she planned in like a week or 2 weeks or something like that. She ends up staying through the new year. So I think when they're talking about holiday, they're talking about the whole time. And it just so happens that we get a chunk of that that's around Christmas and New Year's. So it's not really a traditional Christmas movie. There are some elements of that in there, but it is an endearing movie in its own way. Performances are really good. Rob Lowe especially, I really liked him, but I like Rob Lowe in everything, as I've already mentioned. So, yeah, just a nice little movie that isn't going to get a whole lot of replay action in my house. It's just one and done for me. But it was a nice little movie. I'm glad I watched it, and I do recommend it as a one-timer. So I'd give this movie a C, you know, as something that's going to be entertaining one time. I don't think it would be entertaining a second time. So Holiday in the Wilderness gets a C from me. Have you seen it? What would you say about it? Let me know in the comments down below. Thank you for being here at the OQ Review, where we talk about all of the geeky, nerdy stuff that we love to talk about. And until next time, we'll see you later. Every single day.